Hello everybody and welcome once again to Mechanism 110. Today, well, I've been doing a few things, but nothing really to do with Mechanism, just a little bit of progressive automation. I've set up two tree farms here, so we're getting a reasonable amount of wood in here, and the axes are actually being fed in from here, so I made some more axes. And the same in here, we're getting plenty of wood in here actually. Have you been using it as well? And reasonable number of saplings. In fact, let's fill up these two hoppers so I don't have to come back. So today, what I'd like to do with the mechanism is to improve the power supply. So the first thing we've got to do, well, there's two choices. Either, let's have a look at what we've got for generators. I can't do it that way, can I? I was pressed to click it. So we've got the gas burning generator. We don't have any gas for that. I think that take. Oh, we do need this one. Yes, that's what we want to do. We want to build the gas burning generator because the bio generator requires mulch, which we don't yet have, or biofuel. And the advanced solar panels and the windmills are actually too far away from where this is actually all happening in the workshop, because we're reasonably underground here. What level are we? 51, so we're just below the sea. So the first thing I've got to do is to produce two things. So we need an electrolytic separator. So let's have a look how we do that, because this will actually be this one that's running off gas. And the gas it's running off is that the right one? Yes, I think so. It's hydrogen. So we need to make the electrolytic separator. So that takes water, splits it to hydrogen and oxygen, and pumps the hydrogen into this generator. The oxygen will be used for the next tier of purification. So it gets used in the purification chamber, which gives you the 3x ore production. So we need the electrolytic separator, which is this one. So to make that, we need 4 iron ingots, no problem, redstone, no problem, enriched alloy, no problem, and this, which is osmium dust, gold dust. That's going to be actually no problem, because we get gold dust out of the enrichment chamber. So let's go and get the materials we need for that, or at least the ores. We'll just take a few. So we've got 25 iron here and a few gold. I'll just take, we only need one, but maybe we need one for each one, so we'll make 3 of those. And some osmium dust possibly we need, and the copper and bronze we don't need yet. The copper and tin. Copper and tin of course makes bronze, that's what I was thinking about. So let's put the 3 gold ore in here. I should also probably produce a basic energy cube. Let's have a look what the recipe for that is, because that's also a basic energy cube. So we need this steel casing, which is steel ingots, which is copper and iron. So we need a few irons, and we need a few osmium ingots and some glass, any sort of glass. We'll need a few of these, so we might as well make a few at the same time. So we'd probably need 16 for 4 of those, as I'm counting. And here we also need these energy tablets. It's just gold and some enriched alloy. In fact, I probably haven't got enough gold. Anyway, while that's cooking, let's make a couple of osmium ones. Let's get those processed and get some more gold. And at the same time, I shall get some charcoal. That's what the tree farms are really for, some to produce some charcoal in enough quantities to be able to heat the generator for the time being. And gold, we need some more gold, so let's take another 6. So we should get out of those 6 12 ingots. So that's finished, we can take those, and now we put those in there. And we needed some iron ingots, didn't we? So let's go upstairs and make, I think, the first machine. Ah. So look, what we got? I'm curious. I've produced some of these, and I've got some enriched alloy. I've got four. Probably need more than four. So again, I'll have to go upstairs. In fact, what is probably a good idea is to bring these ingots downstairs and stuff, isn't it? How much space I've got in my inventory? Plenty at the moment. Let's just take these. So that's control space and click. Brings everything down. And in here, well, I probably could do the same thing. I've got 56 gold here already, so let's bring those downstairs. And a chest. Another chest. I've got two chests there, that's fine. So make a large chest, I think, and another one beside it here. So we'll put the unrefined ores in here, so I can do control shift to get move these up. And quick click sort on that. And the blocks and the other ones we'll put in here. Coal. Oh, coal. Block of coal. I don't think we need a block of coal. And we'll put these in, and the charcoal in here too. So a block of coal probably quite good for the power supply for the time being. Let's have a look. Let's take a few of these out. Obsidian I don't need either. So that's got no power in it at the moment. Let's give it some power. And just come and get the rest of this stuff running here. I've got space now, so control space will bring that down. And that should be everything I need, I think. Actually, I don't have any uses for emeralds as far as I know. Let's sort that. So here we're at. Basically, it sorts it by mods. So Minecraft's at the beginning, and then mechanism comes afterwards. It's probably a good change that to sort it alphabetically, or something like that. Right. So what was the first thing we needed to make? I think I need to make some more redstone. I need to put that in here as well. Nope. Let's put that in here. So let's put in, say, four of those. Because that'll give us the compressed redstone, which is much more efficient. I need to do the same thing for coal as well. So eight of those will do, I think. Well, that's processing. Still got power in. That's good. This one's run out already. And it uses a lot of power, the item anyway. So let's take another four blocks of coal. Let's put four blocks of coal in here. That gives me one spare. But this can actually produce enough power to at least run these two machines. But it's not very efficient. And since last time, they have fixed this bug, so I can now break this universal cable without it crashing like that. If I had to put it back again, because it's probably a good place to have it anyway, because I'm going to expand this, at least in this direction to start with. And then later on we'll have to go to the desert. And one of the things about this is a really good spawn anyway, so the desert's a great place. I'm just wondering if I'm doing that efficiently. Never mind. Because we've also got lava sitting at the back here, heating it up. I wonder if the lava would be also good on the sides. Right. So now we should have some compressed redstone, and now we need to make some compressed coal. The reason we need to make the compressed coal is we need to infuse some iron with that. So let's get the iron out of here. Put those back. And you see here we get compressed carbon in the enrichment chamber. So we can take this carbon here, put that into the metallurgy confuser, and that will give us 160, so that's 16 ingots of iron. So that's about three of those, isn't it? So we put the iron in here, and we should start to get steel. I don't think it's enough. I think we'll need another four Great. Do that. Put that in there and take another compressed coal. So now we've got 210 and 21, that's just correct. And you see we're getting in dust from here, which is actually good, because the next thing we'll have to build after this is a crusher to crush the all sort of things to basically, I think it's clumps, because the output from the purification chamber is clumps. So now we've got six. Well, I shall wait until we've got at least 12 of these, I think. In the meantime, let's put these into here. We don't need these at the moment, do we? So let's sort it again. And the gold dust. I think gold is, that is actually a mechanism, but it's actually going up there. Interesting. So I think we have enough of everything except possibly iron. So let's take the iron. Did I leave it in here? Didn't I? 25. That'll give 50. So let's get those crushed up. I'll put this in here. What have we got here? Four steel dust. That's good, we need the dust into ingots, I think, in all cases. And now we've got to. I'll wait another two and then we'll go and put these in the furnace. That's 12, 16. That's. Oh, that's enriched alloy. Ah. Yes. So I'm going to have to do this twice and put these into the top of here. Well, we could make a hopper. Maybe a hopper's a good idea. In fact, actually, in this case, hoppers are always a good idea. So have I got a chest with me? No. Right, quickly, let's go make a hopper. Because I want to show you some of the other things that have been happening in the base. Oh, look, the dogs are growling. That means it's either night time or there are mobs about. Actually, I don't see any mobs, but it is night time. I was looking at the minimap. Right. So we need five ingots of iron. I've got mouse tweaks on, so I can do the scrolling of mice anyway. It'll via that one chest, give me one hopper. Let's put the hopper on top of here. And I think that's the default place, so shift right click the hopper on the face I want it to be on. So what I want to do now is I want to put some more coal in there. We need three more. We made five, so we can put that straight in, that's no problem. That'll go into this slot here, and then we'll put the enriched iron at the top here, and when this is then empty, it'll then start to fill up. Put the other six in here. I'll have to come back anyway. So we've got 60 now. Let's let this process and just check that we actually have got enough heat. We haven't. So I'll take another couple of blocks of iron and coal and put those in here. This is working as well, but it's too slow for the with the lava. This lava just ticks it over. So one of the things I've been doing is fishing. So I'm actually, first thing to do is to go to sleep because it's night time. What I want to do later on is to actually create a farm. I'm using progressive automation. I thought it was quite a good one. All right, some mobs caught on something there. Burning up somewhere. I don't know where they are. There's one over looking at the minimap behind me there. Right, so first thing is here. I created a little automatic fishing place, but I haven't got the fishing rod. Let's go into here. This is where I'm keeping the fishing stuff. Ah, yes, that's where the chest is going to be. So, the fishing rod should be in here. So I've got a great fishing rod here, and I caught it basically by fishing for a long time. So you've got Luck of the Sea, Mending, and Breaking 3, and Lure 3. And I think that that's about as maximum you can get for fishing rods. This is a chest here, and the idea of this is that on top of the chest there's soul sand. I went to the Nether, and the Nether's actually a great spot. I'm just outside in the Nether fortress. So what you do is you hold down the right mouse button, and it closes the iron trap door, which I think is a new feature since 1.9 or something like that of Minecraft, and just hold it down. In fact, I've got a mouse button I can press which will keep it pressed down. So if I press it, did I catch something then, or was it just a chance? I should have a mouse button pressed. So you hold the mouse button down however you do want to do it, and after a while you'll catch a fish or a fishing rod or a boat like that, or a saddle or something or other. So this time we caught a raw salmon, and I just to move that out of the way, just move off it, come out of here, and then over a period of time they should actually, I thought they would go down into here, but they don't, they go into my inventory. So over a period of time you catch things. So look, I've got chests in here with lots of fish in it, chests here with fishing rods and saddles, and these are, as you can see, reasonably good fishing rods which you can then simply use an anvil to repair, and some XP, some saddles, some bows, quite good bows, and some enchanted books. That's what you're basically getting out of that. I'll put that back. I've got a spare bed in here as well, and a bucket of water. In fact, I'm going to need that extra bucket of water later on. And the mechanism for doing this is the complicated one, but I'll put it in the link. Basically, this is actually made for two pistons, so it reacts quicker. But the simple one is just two pieces of redstone and a torch. But that was very well explained. It's actually really quite a nice device. That's some food over here. Let's just harvest that while we're here. Now, at this stage, I think, do we have something to say? We've got 4 steel dust. Let's get those into this hopper at the top here. What are those dogs barking for? Is there anybody around? Yes, there is a mob right behind me. I'll leave him. They don't care at the moment. So it sounds like everything is finished here. So we've got 50 iron dust, 6 enriched iron, and I put those in there, and they should then be fed through into the hopper. Ah, that's not going in. So the reason for that is I have to reconfigure this. So we need to say that the red sign is the input. We make this dark red on the top, and that should then become an input. And it then starts to get the enriched iron from the hopper and be fed into the output. The output in this case is just going to be here. I don't have anything else for it. So while that's all working, let's get upstairs. And do I need any iron dust for anything? Possibly. It's not in the furnace. What's in the furnace at the moment? Nothing. Yes, I need some charcoal in the furnace, don't I? And I've taken it all downstairs. We can get some of that. That's so funny, listening to those dogs growling. I'll take 20 of those, I think. Because we should be getting plenty of wood in now, so we can make lots of charcoal. In fact, let's go and do that. Let's go and sort out that skeleton. It's a big nuisance. It must be over my head somewhere. I can't see it, of course. I can hear him though. Where is he? Oh, there. Oh, it's a baby. These are really hard, actually. Right, not too bad though. He was hiding under a tree because he didn't want to get burnt up. Anybody else around over here? Some more over here, actually. You can see them. This auto jumping in 110 is actually also a bit irritating as well as being good. Where are they? Over here. be somebody hiding behind trees, I think. Yeah, there we go. Now oh, there's one. We missed him. Oh, dreadful. Not that time though. Right, there, sorted out. No more growling dogs. But bones, that's actually quite a good thing to have anyway. I think I can jump off here, let's have a look. That doing you full damage, I can. Whee! Splash, got it just. In fact, let's go and have a look quickly while we're doing this. You'll see you're actually getting these huge spruce trees. Because they're a bit, because the it actually becomes critical, but it's, it takes quite a long time. So you got now plenty of wood in here, you see, and reasonably good number of saplings, and that's and this is actually already used three of the axes. This is used two, so they get used up fairly quickly. I could upgrade these to stone, but what was critical here was the actual range. So I had to add 18 upgrades to get this to be big enough to actually produce wood. In fact, this one is actually hardly producing any wood. It probably needs to be bigger. But the spruce tree one is producing plenty of wood. So we'll take 62 of those. Make some more charcoal. So now we're producing the materials. We should go on and build what we need to build. So what have we got in here? That's been all processed. Let's chuck the wood in there while we're getting the other stuff out of here. Oh, five ingots only. I need a lot more. I've got the iron as well. Let's put the iron through first, I think. Like that. And then the charcoal can be made afterwards. I also need to get the rest of the steel because we're going to need a lot of that. Yes, it's already run out of power. Let's do that. Let's put these 20 charcoals in here. See, charcoal hardly makes anything at all. This is why the power bit becomes quite critical. So we need to get this updated. Maybe need some more in here. Let's take another 4 blocks of coal. Right, that's. We should now have a reasonable amount of power being produced. It's not going up there, so it must be being used up in these two machines. That's full. So the metallurgic infuser is at least running through fairly quickly. So the first thing to do, let's get the first machine made. And I think we need to make... we will leave the basic energy cube. We need that a second. Let's get up to the separator because that's the most important part of the next stage, the electrolytic separator. So that's enriched alloy. We've got four of those already, and this takes 5. So we need at least 7 enriched alloys. We're only going to double that because we need at least 14 of those. So 7 enriched alloys, so that's basically iron and redstone. How many have we got in here? Just 4. I'll take those 4, it'll give me 16, I think. And iron ingots will be upstairs. So let's get these into the enrichment chamber. Into here first. They won't go through until the rest has gone through. So we need to go and get some more iron, or take the iron out of here. Put the iron out of here. Put the iron into the hopper. And then wait for these. In fact, we can take these 12 out of here and get these into the furnace as well. Should probably bring the furnace arrangement downstairs as well, shouldn't I? But later on we'll make an electric furnace, so for the time being. How many have we got in here? 36. That's quite a few. So I'm going to have to move those out of the way and get this done here. Move these second. Get the iron in here because we've got enough iron for the time being. And we've got, you see, 59 in here. And now we're starting to get the steel in. That should be enough for the time being. Let's put away the skeleton. These sticks, we don't need those bones. I'll take some more food. Actually, I get enough food from just two melons. If I need to eat, then fill up my tent. Taking a hit from that skeleton actually used up a heart. So how are we doing now? One chamber, of course. Seven more of these. I really do need to wait for these to finish. And we'll put the iron into here just to make sure we've got plenty of iron in there. The other one we need to make are the other items. Which are these? Which is exactly the same process. So redstone plus... Right, for that matter, I'll make some more redstone in the enrichment chamber. With osmium ingots instead of iron ingots. That's fairly straightforward. I hope. You'll see this is taking quite a long time because the machines are fairly slow. But the next level, you can't do it with the enrichment chamber. I think you can. Let's have a look. It's possible to get an enrichment factory, I think. Yes, it is. So you've got three levels of factories. And the basic one is actually surprisingly not that difficult. It's taking the existing enrichment chamber and adding to it four redstone, two iron. So we could do that, plus these two basic control circuits. And those ones are just simply the redstone and the osmium ingots. Right, sounds like it's quiet for a minute or two. Now, what's wrong with Iascos? That was 40, and in here we have 320, so I'll get 32 of those. And then we'll come over to the furnace here, and it's doing the iron now. Let's put that into there and get the rest of this steel made, because we need that steel urgently as well. And it's got plenty of cobble charcoal in there. Right, there we go. 17, that's a strange number. 17 steel. Okay. We won't do that one yet, but we will. It isn't a bad thing to do because it does speed the process up fairly quickly. So we first of all need the separator, don't we? So we need one of these. Now, have we got enough gold dust, iron, iron dust? Ah, and osmium dust. I'm about to put another one of these through the purification chamber. This will get four of those. Enrichment chamber, I mean. Osmium dust we do have. Gold dust we do have. Gold ingots we have. Redstone we have. We actually got plenty of redstone blocks as well. Take these and these. Hopefully we've got some more of those by now. 10, good. So let's put this machine together now. I should have iron dust. Okay, we should have some of that as well. Yes, we've got four of those now. So with JEI, you'll notice that you can missing items, so we actually shorted two iron ingots, that should not be a problem, and this one. And as you hover over it, it shows you which of the missing bits. So if I press shift click on here, it'll tell me I can make two. Well, actually I do want two, so I'll take two of those. So we need one for this machine and one for the heat generator, or the gas burning generator. So we need some more iron ingots. What are we doing for stuff like that? Which you can got plenty in here as it happens. We got in here 18, so I've got to take out up to 18 of those. That'll do fine. In fact, I'm going to take out another half of those, because the rest I'd like to do is to put some osmium and ingots in there. I can't remember where they are. Put those in there, and then that will actually then produce the control circuits. So here we go. So that's now made. So what are we missing now? Items. So here we got one electrolytic separator. The problem with this machine is it needs energy to power it. though it's one of these catch-22s. So what we've got to do is to move the lava out of the way. Have I got another bucket? Yes, I have. Good. And I'm going to wait for the energy to run out of here, because it's a good idea to use as much of it as possible. What have we got left in his heat generator? Is empty. Good. No more power in that. And then everything is currently finished. So it's run out of power. That's okay, because we're going to do this first of all. Let's get these stuff beaten down out of the way, and that one as well. What we need to do now is to power both these two machines, and we're going to use a heat generator to do that. So that should break without breaking, as it were. So now we need the electrolytic separator to get power. That's going to feed the hydrogen generator. So if we put the electric separator, say, down here. Yes, that's working. I think that's connected. Looks like to me it's got connections on all sides. That's wrong. It should be facing it. Now, we haven't built a wrench yet. We need to build a wrench too, which is in fact called a configurator in... Oops, wrong way. I have to do it the other way. From this side. By the looks of it, if I can get here. Maybe I can't do that now. And hydrogen is going to come out of one side. I think it is the left-hand side it comes out of, which is good. So the next machine we need to know is the heat generator. No, wrong. It's the gas burning generator. This one. So for that we need two steel casings. So we need glass as well. So we need 8 glass. And I don't have any glass at the moment in here. So I have to quickly go and harvest some glass, which is sand in there. Maybe I have got some upstairs. Let's have a look. Got 5 in here. It's not enough. I need another 5. Right, what time of day is it? Night time. So we're going to have a quick sleep. The days go very fast. I've been playing Galactic Science, where the days are very long. I think they're about almost like 30 minutes long or something like that. Or maybe 40 minutes. They're really, really long. I haven't timed them, but they're long. Any mobs around? Nope. Right, good. In fact, we have plenty of sand around here. Let's just take some of this, I think we'll do. I'll replace this with dirt later on. Right, take that one as well. I added progressive automation, by the way, because I didn't really want to do the farming myself. Let it get on and do it itself. So what do we need? Glass. Uh-oh. I picked up all that sand and forgot to put it in the furnace. So let's do that now. Still doing iron. What have we got here? Iron dust. Okay. Oh, I need the iron dust, don't I? So let's put the glass in here first of all and get some glass out. In fact, we'll keep these iron dusts. Sort out inventory so it puts things together. And that was a middle click I used to sort in this case. So we need another 3 glass. I think it's 3. I think it's 8, isn't it, for the gas. Let's have a quick check. Yes, it's 8. Osmium ingots and iron ingots, that should be no problem. One more, and then we have enough for the 2 machine frames. Osmium ingots we got here, so let's get those out. And that down, we should be able to make this thing. So if shift click on the plus, it should move all of the items in, so we get 2, which is great. Over here, now what have we been missing from here? Now 3 osmium ingots, only 3 osmium ingots. Oops, missed. Let's just get the 3. Did I get 4 out of there? Need. And here we go. So shift, and we have now one gas burning generator. So I think what we'll do now is we'll put this one right beside here. I'm too far away. Good. Now we need to give this thing some power, and I think I can do that from here. So let's just knock away this here, and if I put onto this one energy conduit, we've got one there, we should have another few around somewhere. But I'm sure we have. I made some last time. I think they might be in this chest here. Here we go. Advanced pressure tubes and basal universal cables, which we should take down. So is there anything else in here that's relevant to mechanism? Not that I can see. Most of that's progressive automation now. So the idea is here, I'm going to put the generator down here, and then behind it, I'm going to have a space for the lava to flow. So we should be able to knock out these two sides in here, and that should do the trick. And then I'm going to put the heat generator down here. I'm going to put on it lava, but before I do that, I need to put in it some cobblestone, I think. Let's put down the, that now, that's what we'll do. I'll put down this energy conduit here. So that's now connecting up. And I just need to knock out these two here because they won't run down the side. And then I can put on the front here some protection from the lava. It would actually be good to put glass here, but oh, we've got a spare piece of glass. But for the time, we should also get the lava running around the back, don't we? So let's knock out these two pieces here. Have I done that? Yes, look. So now we need to protect the front of this. So, but it would be good to use glass because then you can see it. And it also makes light in the room, so we should have some more glass ready. Ah, plenty of glass. Now it's already starting to do the charcoal, so that's good. Well, let's put that charcoal in here, keep things going. And down the steps one more time, and hopefully for the last time. So what I want to do now is to put a piece of glass on the top there. So what I'm going to do is put a piece of cobble here, and then put one piece of glass here, and then put the lava bucket on top of here. And I think, I hope, I've got everything covered. So if I put it on top of here like this, and shift click it, now that should just drop down there without coming into the base, which is great. Then I can take away this cobblestone from here. And then this should be then getting power. Unfortunately, I can't see. Let's have a look in here. We should get a little bit of power into here. Now this thing needs water, which is the next problem. So what I need to do is to make a water supply. Let's have a think, how am I going to do this? I know. Let's just knock out these three. Yes. Let's knock out these four. I'll do it like this. I think that's okay. Yes, it is. So we'll take these two buckets of water, put one in that corner there, and get the other one. Put that in this corner here. And we now have our infinite supply of water, which we can then take. I think we just have to push those into here, and it starts to produce hydrogen. Now what we need to do to automate this is to produce a pump. Let's get those two, put those two in here, make sure we've got enough water in there. And basically that'll work for a while, and we're just not for very long. As you can hear, it's actually not working very well because it's not got any power. Just to start it off, let's just put some water in manually, and that should then be feeding hydrogen into here. Let's have a look, see if it's getting any hydrogen. Yes, it is. As you can hear, it's getting very little hydrogen. So it really does need a lot more power at the back. And I can't get to that, can I? What would happen if I knocked away this? Would I end up with a cobblestone block? Yes, I do. Which is not what I want. But I do want to be able to put some more power into here for the time being. Block of coal. Let's put some coal into here. And then I put the cobblestone back again. It's probably just filled up my water supply with a cobblestone. That's just cool. Can I reach that? Yes, I can. Good. Now, let's put that cobblestone back into here. I want it there like that. Wait for those to go. What does that make? Stone. That's interesting. Didn't make cobblestone. Dropping on the water. Not surprising. Right, now things are running. But at least this is starting to get oxygen in here. And it's empty in here because all of that's going into this here. A reasonable rate, probably just about maintaining enough power, and that then should be charging up these machines. So as you can see, this is now full of energy, and this is also full of energy, so it is now working. But I need to go and get some more water, and next time we shall carry on and make the automation of that. So until next time, bye for now.